All right, guys, another day back here in the shop. We got our rotating assembly in, at least like the rods, crank, pistons, that's all in there, torqued on, ready to go. Next, we'll go ahead and get our camshaft tossed in here.
See, we got everything all set up here. Looking nice. So, go ahead, got our table cleared up here. We got our camshaft, we got our new timing set, new timing chain. We got our cam retainer in here. And we also have our oil pump. We'll go ahead and get that knocked out today. Yeah, lifters, trays, and then our push rods, which I don't know if we'll get to today just yet. But yeah, let's go ahead and get you guys set down. Let's get started here. All right, we went with a Stage 2 centrifugal supercharger cam from Brian Tooley. Here's the cam specs for anyone that's interested in it. We got 221 on the intake, 240 mystery on the exhaust, 619, 617 lift with a 113 LSA. Should work out perfect for our application. Let's get this thing all lubed up and we'll send it in place. All right, I like to take a screwdriver, put it in this camshaft to kind of give you a little bit of leverage here once we get to the bottom couple of cam lobes. Let's go ahead and lube this up. Kind of just put it all over everything. Don't be shy with it. It's kind of hard to use too much. Feel this go in a little bit. Just kind of feed her in. Really do your best not to bang the cam lobes on the cam bearings there. Definitely don't be scratching that up. Let's come back here through the top. Just goop her up. It's gonna be a mess, but that's okay. Don't be worried. So just kind of get up all in there with it. Put it all over everything. I'll say that freaking assembly lube is cheap, so don't be worried. Don't be bashful with it. Oop. Just kind of get her in place. Lube her up some more. Man. Being a bit of a pain. I get the hammer. Just kidding, we shouldn't be doing that. Man. A little bit tighter than I'd like it to be, honestly. That sucks. Something's kind of getting in a bind here. I don't like it. Weird. This should not be dragging that much. All right, we ran a bit of an issue here. Messed up. We installed this back one or two cam bearings because this thing is tight. It should not be tight. The thing should just float back and forth, but this thing did not go in very easy. So that sucks. I don't know what we're gonna do. Hopefully I can fish a freaking cam bearing up in there with the bottom end still in, which I doubt it. Dude, if I have to take this thing back apart, I'm gonna fucking lose my mind.
Yeah, that sucks. Shit happens though. It's gonna be easier to go ahead and do it now than freaking take the thing out of the car.
All right, guys, we're back. A little bit better mood here. We went ahead and got that cam bearing swapped out. That was causing our problem. It's all good to go now, so.
We are all back together here. I had to take out the back four cylinders so I could fit the cam bearing up underneath there. It was kind of a pain, but that's why I didn't record it. It wasn't a very good angle, but let's go ahead and get you guys set down. Let's finish this install.
Get it in here and get it started at least. Okay, set this thing down. Get some more lube up on it. Hopefully this is the last time we'll be seeing this camshaft for a little while. Just kind of rub it all up over it. In we go, nice and easy. This is where we're getting tight last time, if you guys remember. Sauce it up one more time. Ooh. Getting maybe a little panic there for a second. And look at that. Right where she's supposed to be. Bingo. Look at that. Perfect. Okay. There she's in. Now we just gotta go ahead and get our timing set. And get that locked on there.
All right, time to go ahead and toss in our cam plate retainer, or our cam retainer. So see here, it's got a O-ring here. Now, whenever you're doing this, it's always important to go ahead and just change this out, because if this gasket is bad, you'll have low oil pressure. So important. It's a cheap part, just change it. Another thing to note is that this one happens to have a beveled bolt. Now make sure you're not mixing beveled and flat headed bolts for these things, because there's two different styles out there. So if you get the get an ARP one, you know, make sure you're using the right stuff, or else you'll just set yourself up for failure. We'll go ahead and we're gonna put some blue Loctite on this. It's not required. It's just personal preference for me. I'm just gonna go ahead and do it because I don't like stuff falling out of engines. But let's go ahead and get this thing some, I can't even speak. Let's go ahead and get some Loctite on these things. We'll get them torqued down to 18 foot-pounds.
Okay. It's gonna get set in right there. Now, if you ever plan on taking something out, always use blue Loctite. I mean, it makes it a pain to take off, but it's not impossible. Red Loctite is something you don't plan on taking out unless you're breaking bolts. But as just personal preference, like I said, it doesn't say to do it in the instructions. It's just something I'm going to do, just a little peace of mind. Any fastener inside the block that is not an ARP, that doesn't have specific ARP instructions, I will personally put blue Loctite on. But ARP stuff, I follow that stuff down to a T, all those instructions. But you can do it whatever way you want. It's just my personal preference. And a lot of people out there, it's a, everyone has their own opinion, which is fine. Everyone's entitled to their own opinion. This seems like difference between having an opinion and being extremely opinionated. I should say that. But yeah, this is just what I do. All right, let's get these torqued down to 18 foot-pounds. There you go, easy as that. All right, next we'll go ahead and get our timing set on here.
All right, we're getting ready to go ahead and press on our crank gear. We need to, hopefully, you still have an old one laying around. I've actually had two of them that I scrapped. Ahoff luckily held on to his old one, so really helped us out. This obviously gets lined up in the keyway on the crank. Like that. Take your old one, kind of slide on like so. And then take a harmonic balancer installer. Some people probably use a fucking hammer, it's fine. Just don't tell anybody. So I'm just gonna thread it on like so. And drive it in and press on that crank gear. All right, get this threaded in there so you get some good thread engagement. Don't wanna be freaking folding threads over trying to press this on, which it shouldn't have that much resistance, but I'll go ahead. Make sure everything's looking good. So hopefully this crank doesn't spin too much. Oh, it does. So. I'm an idiot. Gotta have a deep well socket for this, obviously. You guys get creative with how you wanna keep the crank from going over. You can probably just put some flywheel, not really flywheel, but yeah, flywheel bolts in the crank to hold it. But I don't feel like fishing those out of my boxes, so we're holding the old gear. For anyone watching, it's kind of a given. But go ahead and press that on until she stops. I suppose you probably could use an impact, but I'm slowly maturing and not trying to grab the impact for everything. Last thing I'm gonna do is strip something out in the crank. We're this far into it, you know? So you'll feel it stop, it'll come right there. That's it, that's all she's gonna go. You just back this off. It comes right out. That is in there. Bingo. Cool. Well, if you guys can see here, there's a dot right here and a dot right here. These need to be pointing towards each other directly across. So once you get that lined up, you're good to go. Double checking, there is no mark on this chain. So you just kind of go on with it. All right, slide that back up. Line up your holes on everything. Or it can be a little cantankerous. There. Pretty sure that's it, right there. Perfect. Let's go ahead and put on our cam bolts and torque it down. These go to 25 foot-pounds. Perfect.
All right, guys, and that's it. Let's double check. Moved a little bit here. Spin it back some. See, we got our dots directly across from each other. Now on these iron blocks, they do not have timing chain tensioners. I know those LS2 style plastic ones, ICT Billet makes a kit. It's like a little jig that goes on here. You drill and tap them. Not that important for us. So we're not going to be running one. No big deal. But yeah, we'll keep plugging along here. All right, guys. We're going to be running these LS7 style lifters. These are the Morel 7717. These are tried and true proven unit. Let's go ahead and get these things soaked. There's a back and forth debate whether you need to soak these lifters or not. I'm just gonna play it safe. I'm just gonna go ahead and soak them. It's not gonna cost me anything but time. So let's go get these tossed in and give them some oil. All right, we got our lifters in there soaking. It's a big back and forth thing on the internet whether you need to do this or not. I went ahead and did it just to be safe, but basically you just fill this thing up and you kind of keep them in there, toss them around a little bit gently until there's like no more bubbles coming out. You just wanna try to get all those oil cavities and bearings, everything all lubed up for sure. Not that big of a deal. I mean, everyone's allowed to do what they want. That's just what I did.
So we'll go ahead and load these up in these lifter trays here. And then we'll go ahead and get them set in the block. All right, we got our lifters and our trays here. Went ahead and made these oil dots, these like little oil patches, be on the top side of these. I don't think it's that important, but I know I just want to kind of keep everything the same. Just kind of line these lifters up. You don't have to force this too much. They should kind of just kind of come in nice and snug like that. And perfect. Now this gets torqued down to 9 foot-pounds, which is, I think, like 109 inch-pounds, something like that. So we'll go ahead and set this torque wrench. It only goes down to 10 foot-pounds, but I kind of got a little gauge on here. You can see it climb. We'll stop at 9. Easy peasy. I'll double check this one. Yep, just like so.